Welcome, my dear students and friends. In today's session, day 3, we'll see about the SolidWorks, some more components that is there in the SolidWorks actually. So we are in day 3. This session we'll see about the extruded boss with more options, revolve boss, sweep boss with more options, loft boss with more options. Okay, so in place of boss, if you put cut, boss means adding material, cut means removing material. Okay, in this session we'll see about all the adding material part of extruded, extrusion, revolve, sweep, loft, etc. Okay, now let me open let me open a new file again, a new part file. This time again I'll be choosing a right plane. So let me draw a pentagonal prism first, time being. Side of the pentagon is 25. I'll make it vertical, so it is fully defined. Pentagonal prism of side 25 and height 65 maybe. Now it is made. So this is the front view, this is the side view, this is the top view, and this is the isometric view. Okay, so you from here you can keep on adding some more parts also. Now you see, this is the simple extrusion, boss extrude, simple boss extrude. I'll close this one. Simple boss extrude. In that, we'll see about the more options available there. Okay. So this is the button for extrusion. If you click this one, extruded boss, revolve boss, sweep boss, loft boss, or simply extrude, revolve, sweep, loft. So all the commands are available in this particular command button itself. Otherwise, from the pull down menu, under insert, under the boss, you have all this: boss, extrude, revolve, sweep, loft. Okay, now in the design tree we'll see some more options available under this particular command. Okay, let me click this one. If you click this button, the moment I click this particular tab in the design tree, automatically the command options will be popping up. So you can use the option called edit feature. This is the edit feature button. Okay, this is the edit feature button. I'm just clicking now. So you can you see that already I gave the height as 65. Now if you want, you can change it. Okay, it is a blind extrusion. You see, there are, apart from blind, there are some more options available: vertex, surface, from surface, body, mid plane, etc., etc. Okay, so now the same 65, if it is blind, you see from here it extrudes. You see carefully. So this is the sketch that I have drawn. Okay, it is at the bottom, this is the base. Instead of blind, if I choose this mid plane, you see what happens. Mid plane, this is the second option available, another option available under the boss. So this out of 65 by 2, 32.5 this way, 32.5 this way, that is 32.5 in the upper side, 32.5 lower side, bottom side. So 32.5 plus 32.5 is equal to 65. So that is the particular about the mid plane. Okay, the other commands it can be used only if you keep on adding more and more feature. Okay, let it be blind again, now you see this button. This is the button under the dialog box available under the boss extrude called, you can introduce a taper. you can introduce a taper. A taper of say 5 degree. A taper of 5 degree. You see that? Or a taper of 10 degree. Maybe it is still clearly visible. A taper of 10 degrees. Okay, you can give taper. Now you see, press OK. Previously it was a pentagonal prism actually. Now it has got, we should call this as a frustum of pentagonal pyramid. Frustum of pentagonal pyramid. Again, I repeat, if you want to draw, if your intention is to draw a pentagonal pyramid, this is not the command. You should use a different command, the loft command I already told you in the last class. Okay. But if it is a frustum of a pentagonal pyramid, use this taper. Otherwise, if you want the pentagonal pyramid, you should not use this option. You should use the loft option. Okay. So again, go to edit feature. Loft is 10 degree. No. Then there is another option available under the dialog box. Draft. By default, it is draft inward. Okay. Draft inward. Draft outward. If you type, you see it will be enlarging. 10 degree, it goes in an enlarged way. Okay. So in the previous command, the by default it will be contracting. Okay. Tapering in. Okay. So you have these many options. Okay. So draft, if you unclick this one, this will happen this way. Then instead of blind, again, if you use the mid plane, in the mid plane you see from the mid plane, the upper side direction 1, okay, let it be blind, okay, 65. Degree. Okay, so again I go back. So taper is 10 degree inwards. If you click this one, taper outwards. Okay, I don't want taper now. Again, okay, I clear the taper option. So without taper, I have drawn this one. Okay, now you see, suppose if you want to add some more, this is called one feature. The entire thing is called a part. So a part can have many features. At this point of time, this part has only one feature. Boss Extrude 1 is having only one feature called Boss Extrude 1. Okay. Now let us add more and more feature over and above it. Okay. I'll click this as the surface, the datum plane or a reference plane. Let me do some sketch over it. Okay, now here I'll be using a ellipse command. Okay, so I have drawn some elliptical profile. The extrusion it is 50, let it be. Now you see, now as if it is a part, but this part has two features. So any complex part, is a complex profile. That complex profile can be segmentized into number of features. Okay, if you draw all these features, that means you'll be completing the part. Okay, so this particular part as of now has got two features, boss extrude 1, boss extrude 2. Okay, now I'll see the top view now. Okay, from here I want to add one cylindrical piece, something like that. Okay, for that I have to add a new reference plane. Okay, for any sketch, I already told you, for any drawing, any sketch, you need a plane, a reference plane. The default reference planes are front plane, top plane, right plane. Okay, we started this particular object starting from the top plane. Okay, for getting this particular feature, we have chosen this as the reference plane. On this reference, after choosing this as the reference plane, we have drawn the ellipse, then we extruded it. Okay, now I just want to add one more additional cylindrical thing this side. Okay, so for that, my intention is now is from this side, flip offset. Okay, so you see that I am going to have a sketch plane or reference plane or datum plane somewhere here, which is 40 mm away from the center. 40 mm away from the center. Okay, press OK. Again, I repeat, I use this button, plane button. Then a dialog box appeared. Then I created a plane. Okay, now the plane is visible now. Okay. So always it is not advisable, of course. Let me hide the plane. Okay, only that plane is visible only if I click that plane in the design tree. Okay, now after clicking this one, this is the sketch button already. This is the sketch button already. So if I click this one, I am about to draw or scribble something onto this plane actually. Okay, so again I repeat, select the plane first. Then go for sketch. Now I'll be writing something on this particular plane. Okay, normal to sketch. So this is the command called normal to sketch. So this command bar is called standard view. This command bar is called standard view. So to customize all these things, right click somewhere on this bar. So these are the menus, command bar menus available for you. Okay. So you see the task pane already opened, the reference geometry already opened, screen capture already opened, features already opened, sketch, where is it? Yeah, sketch is already open. Now you see that now again, so this sketch, this is the sketch bar, you know. Now you see right click, if I now I'm about to remove that. So the sketch toolbar is removed now. Right click, sketch toolbar is enabled. You can enable and disable this way. So in this command bar, keep the cursor somewhere here, press right click. So you can switch on and switch off the command bars, whatever you want or whatever you don't want. Okay, now I am inside this particular, I am on this particular sketch. Whatever I scribbled, I am not scribbling anywhere. I will be scribbling somewhere on this one. Okay, so normal to plane. Let me draw some profile, something like that. Escape from that particular command. So a circle is drawn. You see that this is on that plane. The circle is on that plane. The circle is on that plane. Okay, normal to the plane. Now it covers these three faces actually. Now my intention is to draw a cylindrical object this way. Okay, after exiting from sketch, after selecting the sketch 3, you can go for extruded boss, or otherwise straight away you can click extruded boss also. Okay, now because let us speed up the work, okay, a bit faster. So straight away, even instead of exiting from the sketch, I can straight away invoke the feature command. Okay, extruded sketch. Now you see the blind 50 means it penetrates up to this. This is not advisable. Here use those options up to surface. Now I'll be showing the two options. From this you can understand the difference between the two options. Okay, first let me choose up to surface. Okay, now I choose up to surface. This circle will be extruded up to this surface. Now press OK. You see what happens? This circle is extruded up to this particular surface only. It is not crossing beyond. So this is the thing that you will be getting. Now edit the feature. Up to surface is over now. Now I go for edit. instead of up to surface, up to next I'll be choosing up to next this way. You see what happens. So at this particular phase, it ends up to this, but it covers these three phases also. The extrusion covers these two phases also. So that is the difference between up to surface and so the options are blind, mid plane, up to surface, next. So these are the options that we used in. So we already saw about mid plane, blind, and mid plane means blind. The difference between there is not much difference between blind and mid plane. Suppose say I used a 65 value, extrusion height in blind, and 65 means the extrusion will be in one direction only. Mid plane means the 65 will be divided by 2, 32.5 upper side, 32.5 bottom side. If it is 65, if it is 70, 35 upper, 35 lower. Up to surface and next. Now I showed you now. Okay, so you have to choose the options according to your requirement only. Let me save this as my exercise number 4. Okay, so what are the other options you have? I think only these options are sufficient, and some more options are through all. Required only in the case of cut, not in the boss. Okay, the vertex and all up to a particular point. Instead of surface, you can choose the vertex, a point. Offset from surface. Yes, offset from surface. That is also not so useful for the boss, of course. It will be useful for the cut actually. Not for adding material, it will be useful for removing material, while removing the material. Okay, so I think with these things you can do so many things in developing any product. Okay, so this is okay. Now shall we see the revolve boss now? Okay, so this is exercise number 4 over. For exercise number 5 we'll choose for revolve. Yeah, revolve. Okay, shall I close this one? Okay, I'll close. I'll open a new file to know about the revolve. Okay, revolve boss. A revolve example for the revolve is a ring ball or a spear, a cylinder, a cone. So in this exercise 5 revolve, I'll be showing you how to draw cylinder, cone, ring, and some more shapes in the same exercise. Okay, now let us say a cylinder 60 by 90, that means a diameter 60, height 90. For the revolve this time I'll be choosing a front plane. Okay, then I'll be drawing a rectangle whose height is 90 and the side is not the diameter, the radius 30. Again I repeat, Here 60 is the diameter of the cylinder. Let me insert that symbol. That will be better. You know that pi is the symbol. Okay, pi is the symbol for the diameter. If the diameter is 60, what is the radius? 60 by 2, 30. So I have drawn this one. I have drawn a rectangle. Now, without exiting sketch, already I told you, you can exit. You can choose the sketch, then you can go for the revolve. Or otherwise, while you are inside the sketch, straight away you can execute the command. So revolve. Revolve about this axis, a 360 degree revolve. Or if it is 180, you see what happens. Only half of it. If it is 360, full. If it is 90, only a quarter portion. So let it be 360. So now you see that if you double click this one, those two values are available. So 90, the radius, if the radius is 30, diameter is 60, of course. Okay, now I'll be slowly telling you about some of the enquire commands also. Okay, so the enquire command, this is the command for called measure. Side by side I'll be telling about additional commands also. To enquire about entities. To enquire about entities. Okay. Measure is one command. This is the button for enquiring. So click this one, a dialog box will appear. Now you see, if I click this one, you'll get to know about the particulars. It is a circle, or edge is anything but a circle whose diameter is 60. Not only this diameter, you'll be getting the length. Here the length is the perimeter, the circumference of the circle. Pi d, pi 60 is 188.5. okay, so if you click this one, this face and this face, you'll get the center distance 90. Center distance 90. Okay. So this is a very good tool actually. Now if I click this one, the surface area, the perimeter, diameter, so many other particulars, the relevant particulars you'll be getting. Okay. So this is one enquiry command. The another enquiry command is mass properties. Mass properties. Now you see, if you click this one, the center of gravity, mass center point, the moment of inertia about x, about y, about z, least moment of inertia, so many particulars will be getting. The mass, the density, the mass, assuming the density is, density of the material is 1, the mass is 254 millimeter cube. Okay, so in centimeters, if you want to convert that into centimeter, 254 centimeter cube, let it be 250 centimeter cube means it is a quarter liter. One full liter is equal, 1 liter is equal to 1000 cc centimeter cube. It is 250 centimeter cube roughly. Okay, it is a 250 ml exactly. That is a volume. So all these things will be getting here in the mass property. Okay, so from the revolve we have made this cylinder. Our first exercise was drawing circle and extruding, we obtained cylinder. Now drawing a half rectangle revolving about one longer edge, you'll be getting a cylinder. Now Let me explain. Now I'm just editing the sketch. You see what happens. I'm about to edit the sketch. I deleted these. Now you tell me what I will get. What thing I will get? Radius is 30, height is 90. What I will get? I'll get a. You see, from here it is visible. The moment I exit, what you obtained is a cone. So for cone, again I repeat, draw the triangle, okay, such that this is the axis, this is the radial line, and this is the generator. It is a right angle triangle. It must be a right angle triangle for the cone, of course. So this is how we obtained, okay. Now I'll delete. So here in this problem itself, a cone also, for the cone also, the diameter is 60, let's see. Then I think SPHERE, sphere also we'll see. Sphere of diameter 60. Sphere of diameter 60. Okay, so we have seen cylinder now. We have seen cone now. Let us see about the sphere of diameter 60. Okay, so let me, here itself I will do. Let me edit this one. First, let me draw a circle of diameter 60. Then I will draw a diameter line vertically. Then let me trim the unwanted portion. A half circle, semicircle I will be drawing. So what is the diameter of the circle? 60. Radius means 30. Okay. So it gives some error, right? It gives some error because the central axis is not defined this time because I have deleted all the entities now. Edit that revolve. Axis of revolution is missing now because I deleted the rectangle or the triangle that I drew previously. So some data or entity were lost. Because of that, it tells some error. No problem. So under the axis of revolution, if I select this diameter line, you see what happens. It's a sphere. It's a sphere. Okay, now you can see that as the sphere actually. Okay. In the same problem, now I have covered about cylinder, cone, sphere. Now a ring, or it is called a torus, in the same file without deleting anything. Of course, I have to delete this one. Let me, for it better, I delete this one, delete the feature, I recreate a feature, that will be better. So I am editing the sketch. I have deleted this one horizontally. This ring is some distance away. Now you see carefully now, first time I am using a center line. If I click straight away, you are about to draw the object line. Instead, by clicking this pull down option and this center line, now I will be drawing a center line here. So this is called the center line or axis line or construction line. Okay. So about this one, this will be rotated. Okay. For that, you need axis of rotation. So this is not the part of the object. The object is circle. Okay. Now straight away let me use the revolve. Now you see it is automatic. Now you see this is the object circle, about this it will be it has been revolved, rotated. So you get a ring shape. Okay. So in between, in addition to this, we have seen the measure enquire command, mass property enquire command. You will see about one more command, section view. Section view command also now. Section view command also. Now this is the section view command. You are temporarily cutting the profile, and you are just seeing. You are not actually cutting the profile. So this is the section. You can switch off the section. Again, you switch on. You can change the plane also, of course, if you want. You are not cut the object actually, okay? For visualization purpose only, you have sectioned and you are observing. You can choose another section plane. You see? Okay, so this is another enquiry type of command. Okay, so these things, enquiry commands, are really useful. You should use often to draw the feature or the part more precisely. Okay, so exercise 5 is over now. In this, we have seen cylinder, cone, sphere, ring. Okay, now we see about the boss. Loft you have seen yesterday already, but again we will see some more options. Let me save this as exercise 5. Okay, let me close this one. I'll create another file, exercise 6 file, for the sweep. New file, part. Okay, before seeing about the exercise, first of all you should know what is required for the sweep. You need two sketches. One is a profile sketch and the other one is path sketch. For sweep command, if at all if you want to use the sweep command, two sketches you need. Okay, go back to our very first exercise, cylinder. Only one sketch. Circle was the sketch. You extruded the circle, you obtained cylinder. So only one sketch. But here for the sweep you need two sketches. One sketch is called profile sketch, other sketch is called the path sketch. Okay, the profile sketch must be a closed profile. And path sketch must be a open profile. These are again very important. Okay, a circle is a closed profile. A C, letter C symbol, is not a closed profile, it is an open profile. Okay, so you need two sketches. Now let me open a center rectangle. I am using another command now. Okay, center rectangle or corner rectangle, two ways are possible. Center rectangle in a crossed way. Okay, let me use a center rectangle. From the center rectangle, I want to draw a square. So if we drag this way, you see it becomes rectangle. Okay, here also you see that these four edges are drawn by thick continuous line type. So that means these are all the object lines. The diagonal lines are of construction line type, center line type. So this is not the part of the object actually, right? So okay, let it be rectangle. Of course, I want this to be say 30 mm, and this is just 10 mm. Now everything is black, it is fully defined. So I said for the sweep you should have two sketches. One sketch is made. What is a sketch? Is it a profile sketch or a path sketch? Profile sketch must be a closed one, path sketch must be an open one. So it is a closed one. Rectangle is a closed one. That means it is a profile sketch. Okay. Now let me exit. One sketch, sketch one is over. It has been drawn on top plane. So the other path sketch, you know, that should be on the some other plane. That should be on the some other plane other than top plane, because I chose top plane for drawing this sketch. So now let me choose the right plane and go for sketch. Normal to plane. This time I'll be using a three point arc. Okay, 3 point arc. You see carefully. So this is the 3 point arc. So if you want, you can give the dimension for it. I don't want to use the dimension now. Okay, my intention now is to make you to understand about what is sweep, how to use the sweep. Okay, so now you see that there are two sketches, sketch one, sketch two. Exit. Sketch one is a closed profile. Sketch 2 is a open profile. That means sketch 1 is a profile, sketch 2 is a path. Okay, shall we go for sweep now? Okay, yes, go to sweep. Now see here, it is a profile. It asks for profile now, then this is the path. In the profile, let me click this one, then immediately it has selected sketch 1 as the profile. For sketch 2, let me choose this one. You see what happens. Okay. Now, sweep is over now. Okay. We'll see some more options. Under the option, profile twist, twist along the path, degrees. A 90 degree twist I want to introduce a 90 degree twist. So sweep is made just like that, but if you introduce a twist, the angle between the start and the end is 90 degree, so it will be twisted. You see that? So 90 degree twist is made. It may be quite confusing for you. Let me reduce the twist angle. Let it be 45. Yes, now you see that it is twisted. Even if you add some more things, it will be really good. Now let me go to sketch. Let me do some filleting instead of sharp corners. For this sketch, this is the command available for sketch fillet. So sketch fillet, the fillet angle, fillet radius must be just 3 mm. I filleted this one, I filleted this, I filleted this corner, I filleted this corner. Right click, you see what happens. So all the sharp corners were removed, all are filleted. Now you see here also it is filleted. Even in the twist also it has been reflected. Still you have many options. Actually I don't want to confirm, because something you can, after gaining some confidence about all the commands, you yourself can explore and test about the more features and options available under each and every command. Okay, so this is a follow path option is very better actually. Okay, let me go back. I'll do some changes in the sketch. Instead of angled one, if it is a straight line, just a straight line, escape, exit, you see what happens. Let me introduce 90 degree now, or even 180 degree this time. See about the twist now. Okay, so this is my exercise number 6. Okay, I will zip it and I'll store it in my Google Drive. So you can download it and you can use it. Okay, give me some time. Okay, maybe after a couple of days let me store all those things in my Google Drive. So if you are interested, you can download those things. Okay, the link I will provide in the YouTube itself, YouTube description itself. So exercise 6 is over. For the lofted boss, we already saw about lofted boss already. So here we used fillet sketch command also we used. The lofted boss exercise let it be 7. Already, let me close this one, or I'll save this as exercise 7. I'll erase this content. We already saw the loft when I saw where exercise 2 pentagonal prism. A hexagonal pyramid has been drawn using loft command. We already saw that, but the loft command is a very powerful command, I could say. It has got many features actually, but I will say only one option, one more option here, but it has got many options actually. So let me restrict at this point of time. This 21 days is not sufficient to cover all those things. The essential things I'll be covering, right? That is a very good thing actually. Okay, here I will see, we will see the two things in this exercise. With it we'll wind up. Transition object, we'll see one transition piece now in this exercise. A transition piece is nothing but the base is having one shape, the top face will be having another shape. So that is the beauty of this one. Okay. Let me choose the top plane. Uh, time, let me use a rectangle command here, a center rectangle. Longer edge 60 mm, shorter edge 30 mm, exit. Now this sketch is drawn on top plane. On top of it, maybe at 100 mm away, I want to draw another profile, right? So introduce a new plane. That new plane should be parallel to this at a height of 100 mm. Click OK. So the distance between these two is, say, distance between these two plane is 100 mm. If you double click it, you can alter the value. You can alter the value. Okay. So hide the plane. Select the plane. Go for sketch. Now you see it is black in color. I did not use anything because auto relation is made. You see this point and this corner, you see this corner is highlighted already. Okay, both are coinciding, that is why auto relation is invoked. So it is fully defined now. Okay, so that means what is the radius? Half the diagonal. Half the diagonal. Normal to the big circle. So the radius of this circle, or the diameter of the circle, is nothing but the diagonal of this rectangle. The diagonal of the rectangle is equal to the diagonal of diameter of this circle. So that is the relation made automatically. Okay, now let me exit. Okay, so select. Press control key and select both section sketch 3 and sketch 4. Go for loft. Now you see, this is called a transition piece. Okay, so bottom is a rectangle, top face is a circle. The in-between section profile is neither rectangle nor circle. I'll show you. Now you see the profile keeps on changing. You see carefully, watch carefully. Now you see that top is a perfect circle. Slowly it becomes a different shape. Okay, we can't name that shape, the section profile shape. It is a rectangle. Okay, so this is over. Now I'll delete this one. I'll show you some more options available in this particular thing, right? Now choosing the front plane, select sketch. I want to use guide curves in the loft with some, that is some more options available there. So 3 point, okay, this way. Okay, I don't want to. Okay, let me use 70. Okay, so yeah, another sketch is made. I want to use this as a guide curve. I want to have another guide curve this side actually. Okay, another new file, choosing the front plane, another sketch, the fourth sketch I'll be using. Okay, you see another thing called convert entities. You can get the projection of anything onto this sketch. Convert entities. So I'll be adding some more commands now. So we saw additional commands. What we saw in this session is measure, mass property, section view, fillet sketch, and convert entities. This is very important. Okay, this is very much essential. Okay, select go for convert entities, select this one. Here this is not that much visible actually. Maybe in the some other drawing I'll show you the importance of convert entities. Okay, I want to convert this into construction type, not as the object. I'll be drawing a central line. Okay, so if you are able to understand, good. Otherwise you just skip it, this particular portion alone you skip it. I remove the construction. Now whatever geometry or the specification there in this particular arc, same will be implied here. For that I use the convert entities. Convert entity is nothing but getting the projection of any entity onto this particular sketch plane. Okay, now you see that I have drawn four sketches. Sketch 1 rectangle, sketch 2 circle, sketch 3 this guide curve, sketch 4 this guide curve. Everything is over. Now again you go for loft. Now you see what are the differences. Now profiles, under the profile select these two. If you have selected these two, it will be lofted, you will get a transition piece straight away. Now guide curve option is available in the command itself. Select the guide curve box, select this guide curve, press OK. You see what happens? It is something like a talcum powder container. Okay, so this is exercise number 7. So before winding up, I'll be showing one more command called shell. How to get shell? The shell command can be used on any part or on any feature. Okay, so loft is over. Simple loft we have seen, simple loft and loft with guide curves, these are enough. Okay, there are many options available under the loft. Okay, so after having some expertise, after gain some knowledge and confidence, you can try more options available under loft by yourself. This is the shell button, shell command available, shell. Okay, let us see what happens. Shell command, it is to make convert the, it is something like converting this solid object into a sheet metal. I have selected this particular portion. The shell thickness, let it be just 2 mm or even 1 mm. Press OK. You see what happens? It is clearly visible if I section it. You see that? You get a shell structure. What is the thickness? The wall thickness is 1 mm. In the shell, I chose only the top face. Even if I select the bottom base, you see what happens? The shell is open throughout. Okay, so in today's session we saw about day 3, extruded boss, revolve, sieve with options, loft with options, additional commands, measure, mass property, section view, fillet sketch, convert entity, shell. Okay, this is a sufficient for time being. Okay, thank you. Maybe in the tomorrow session we'll see some more particulars in SolidWorks. Okay, thank you. Bye bye.